The President of the United States is promoting disproven and potentially harmful medical treatments for COVID-19. And I know, look, it's not new, but in recent days, there's been talk among some of the president's supporters that he was now finally getting it, encouraging mask wearing. But of course, once again, he is being incredibly, dangerously irresponsible. He takes no responsibility for it and clearly doesn't care if it harms anyone. Yes, the president can occasionally read remarks written by someone else on a teleprompter that makes it sound like he's being responsible, which he did again this evening. But 149,000 Americans are dead, which this self-proclaimed wartime president again did not mention in his prepared remarks that he was reading off that paper. And like a snake oil salesman, he's still promoting disproven medical treatments. It is unconscionable. And whose medical advice is the president of the United States now promoting? It's not Dr. Fauci, not Dr. Birx, not even Dr. Redfield from the CDC or the Surgeon General who's been actually begging people to wear masks. No, the president is now promoting a doctor whose viral video has been very popular suddenly among QAnon conspiracy theorists and COVID deniers. She's a doctor from Houston who also believes that women can be physically impregnated by witches in their dreams.
It's what we call astral sex. That means this person is not really a demon or Nephilim. It's just a human being that's a witch. And they astral project and sleep with people.
That's Dr. Stella Emanuel, who also has a ministry, who promises on her own YouTube page, quote, deliverance from spirit husbands and spirit wives, parentheses, incubus and succubus, end quote. Last night, the president retweeted this video to his 84 million followers from a press conference she and a group of doctors did yesterday at the Capitol.
I came here to Washington, D.C. to tell America, nobody needs to get sick. This virus has a cure. It is called hydroxychloroquine, zinc, and Zithromax. I know you people want to talk about mask. Hello? You don't need mask. There is a cure. I know they don't want to open schools. No, you don't need people to be locked down. There is prevention and there is a cure.
Now, keeping them honest, just medically, that is simply not true. The most recent study published last week in the New England Journal of Medicine, which is a very, very reputable medical journal, was done on 504 patients across 55 hospitals in Brazil and showed no benefit and also revealed heart rhythm complications, which can be deadly. Other studies agree, and the FDA has revoked its emergency use authorization for hydroxychloroquine. The FDA has done that. President Trump's FDA. And chloroquine for the treatment of COVID-19. One study, which differs and is often cited by the president, has come under criticism for being of a lower quality than the others. But in truth, with tens of thousands of lives on the line, not to mention the distraction this has been for the public health system in the U.S., which is stockpiling this drug, the wartime president, the so-called wartime president's main medical authority, really seems to be this person and himself. And that's not our assessment. It's by his own admission.
As you know, I took it for a 14-day period, and I'm here, right? I'm here. It doesn't cause problems. I had no problem. I had absolutely no problem. And I tested, as you know, it didn't get me, and it's not going to hopefully hurt anybody.
Yeah, let's hope, you know, hopefully it won't hurt anybody. Notice the use of the personal pronoun. I had no problem. I took it. It didn't get me. Again, 504 patients in 55 hospitals in the latest study versus a sample of one who boasted today, quote, I've read a lot about hydroxy. And he said this back in early March.
I really get it. People are surprised that I understand it. Every one of these doctors said, how do you know so much about this? Maybe I have a natural ability. Maybe I should have done that instead of running for president.
Nearly 149,000 dead Americans since he said that. And the president is still, by his own lights, the smartest guy in the room. The bravest wartime president, despite having led an effort that has made this country the object of pity and mockery and laughter in the rest of the world. A pariah whose citizens cannot even travel to most places on earth because of the wartime president's statements and actions. But because every wartime president needs a surgeon general, here again is the candidate that the president of the United States retweeted last night.
We had a lady right here. She was sitting right there. She had been fantasizing about one of the movie stars. When she came to Deliverance Ground, during prayer, she started screaming. Her stomach was full, was pregnant. She started screaming. She was tearing off her clothes. She was screaming and screaming like she was in labor. And she said, this thing came out of me. Her stomach deflated. Right here. Real life.
Kind of makes you miss Chuck Woolery, doesn't it? This Dr. Emanuel apparently believes that lusting after movie stars can conjure demons that can make women physically pregnant with demon babies by impregnating them in their dreams. Again, this evening, the leader of the free world, overseeing the singularly failed response to a pandemic, retweeting her claims about a disproven drug therapy and praising her essentially for agreeing with his non-scientific gut beliefs. Oh, and he also took a moment to say this about the nation's leading expert on the subject.
So, you know, it's interesting. He's got a very good approval rating, and I like that. So why don't I have a high approval rating with respect, and the administration, with respect to the virus? So it sort of is curious. A man works for us, with us, very closely, Dr. Fauci and Dr. Birx, also highly thought of. And yet, they're highly thought of, but nobody likes me. It can only be my personality.
Only my personality, he says. Certainly not Dr. Fauci's actual knowledge and training, his expertise, his humility, and the fact that he's not lying every day, all the time. And maybe it's his decades of, you know, service as a public servant when he could have been making millions of dollars in the private sector. Only the wartime president's personality. Because as any biologist will tell you, to a deadly virus, you know, it's all about personality. In any case, why trust him when you can instead trust the person who speaks about succubuses on YouTube? A woman who recently tweeted a challenge to Anthony Fauci and CNN anchors, apparently, whom she believes are secretly taking hydroxychloroquine. Quoting now, I double dog dare y'all, give me a urine sample. CNN's Caitlin Collins called the president on his support of this person and pressed him on it until he fled the briefing room.
The woman that you said was a great doctor in that video that you retweeted last night said that masks don't work and there is a cure for COVID-19, both of which health experts say is not true. She's also made videos saying that doctors make medicine using DNA from aliens and that they're trying to create a vaccine to make you immune from becoming religious.
Well, maybe it's the same, maybe it's not, but I can tell you this. She was on air along with many other doctors. They were big fans of hydroxychloroquine, and I thought she was very impressive in the sense that from where she came, I don't know which country she comes from, but she said that she's had tremendous success with hundreds of different patients, and I thought her voice was an important voice, but I know nothing about her. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you.
Oh, he went out of the womb. There's too many questions. Not questions I wanted. I'm going to leave. That was that. No more questions. Speaking of Chuck Woolery, it wasn't the first time. Almost 13,000 lost American lives ago, with 136,000 Americans dead. President Trump retweeted a former game show host warning that when it comes to COVID-19, quote, everyone is lying. And what were the former game show host's medical qualifications to back up this warning, not to trust the experts? He sells ointment.
Hey, Chuck Woolery here with a bit of a confession. I have a new favorite emu oil. Forget the imitators. There's only one blue emu. Get American-made blue emu. It works fast and you won't stink.
You won't stink. Tired of that old emu oil. Glad we have some new emu oil. Since then, the ointment salesman's son has contracted COVID and the ointment salesman has deactivated his Twitter account. Today, almost 13,000 American lives later, with the death toll about to pass the 150,000 mark, the president of the United States is back at it, even though he admitted just this past weekend that retweeting has not been good for him.
You know what I find? It's not the tweets, it's the retweets that get you in trouble.
With all due respect to the office, no, Mr. President, they get the people you serve in trouble and cost some of them their lives.